Located at 822 Mass Street in Lawrence, Kansas, Love Garden Sounds has grown over the past 33 years to be one of the most loved stores throughout the community.
When I was a kid, I would say my first sort of full obsession that I can remember was Michael Jackson's Thriller, where I like really needed to know more about this and listen to it a million times. Most of them were short. There were 3-4 minute things because MTV was basically a radio station that played short songs, just music videos. But because this was a big enough hit, I think that's what really drew me in, the whole kit and caboodle of that song. So by like 85, 86, the radio wasn't the same for musical interests really. And at that point I could like, I had plenty of other, like I could go buy my own music. I could get into, I figured out which guy at the mall tape shop would sell like NWA tapes to underage kids. And so that's the shop I went to on the day that guy worked. I was in Washington, D.C. for a year and a half. And so I showed up here not really knowing what I was doing next. And the next day, the owners heard I was back in town and sent somebody to find me. And I bought it in 2004. These physical media can sound better than streaming in a lot of cases, but really it's about kind of the ceremony of here's the thing I care about, I'm putting it on, I'm gonna listen to this thing all the way through in theory. CDs you can kind of skip around on, but still the ceremony is what really builds an emotional connection for people. But it's also like, I have this thing that's relatively permanent, as long as it doesn't burn up or whatever. I have a thing and I can listen to it whenever I want. And I have a finite amount of options, whatever physical media is in front of me. When you have every option in the world, none of the options seem like the right one.
Here's the thing about like listening to like physical records on a record player and then, you know, compared to listening to music on Spotify. Like, we don't pay attention for long. So like, we'll listen to music and it's like, oh, that sounds good. Like, oh, that sounds good. Like, oh, that sounds good. Like, and the problem with that is that we don't actually really listen to the music, you know what I'm saying? Like, there's something truly different when you actually start to like really learn what's like in between the lines, what's in between the bars. You really learn where the artist was coming from and stuff like that, you know? A lot of these things can inspire.